Hello darlings, welcome back to my channel. Today I'm going to be sharing with you guys how I made the quickest, most natural looking crochet lace wig from scratch for only $2. So if you guys have ever wished for a crochet wig that looks just as natural as a lace wig but costs way less than a quarter of the price, you're in the right place and you're gonna love this video. So before we get into the video, I just want to ask that you guys give this video a like. Guys, it's absolutely free, it doesn't cost you anything, and it really helps my channel to grow. So it's an easy way of you guys just supporting me for providing content for you guys. So you can go ahead, like this video, and also subscribe, turn on your post notification, that way you will not miss any of my weekly uploads. And yeah, just keep on watching. So for the wig cap today, I'll be using this one here, and it is a large. They come in different sizes, so you can use a medium. And this is the lace that I'm going to be using to do the wig, and this is how it matches to my complexion. I'll be putting all the products in the description box so you guys can check that out. So I'm just going ahead first and using my tape measure to measure the lace that I'm going to be using. So I'm making a 4x4 closure, so I just measure it about 4.5 inches just to give myself some room to work with. After cutting it out, I'm just going ahead and sewing it down to the wig cap, and I'm sewing it where the L is because I'm gonna just cut that out when I'm finished with the wig. So I decided to sew it in this direction instead of the other side. And I did double sew it, so I sewed it first in one direction and then I just went over that stitch in the opposite direction. Just to ensure that it's secure. Now this is a braid that I'll be using. You guys know I'm always using Outre jumbo braid in my videos. It's kind of the hair that I find the easiest over here, apart from the expressions here, and I just love using this hair. I think it matches the closest to my natural hair, and I just love it. It's affordable and it's just easy to work with. So I'll be using 2 packs of this braid, and I'm just going ahead and I cut the braids in half. So after cutting it, I have 4 portions or 4 sections because I'm using 2 packs, and I'm cutting each pack in half. And guys, I'm just taking a regular crochet needle and then I'm just installing the crochet here around the band first before moving on to the center and to the other portions of the cap. And as you guys can see right here, I'm just using the regular crochet method, and I'm just taking up a small portion of here and just putting that around the band. Now I reached the front of the cap, and this is how I'll be leaving it for right now, and then I'm gonna move to the middle. And this is what it's looking like so far. So now I'm just gonna go ahead and use my scissors to cut out the mesh from underneath the lace. And as you guys can see, I was going a little bit out of frame right here because I was so focused on making sure that I did not cut the lace while I'm taking off the mesh. So now this is how it's looking. without the mesh underneath, looking really nice so far. I'm already excited. So we're gonna go ahead now and do the estimation or the measurements for the lace portion of the wig. So we're gonna go ahead now again with our tape measure, and as I said before, it's a 4.5 inch closure, and I'm just finding the center of that. And yeah, I'm just gonna make a line, but not directly in the center. I want to make the equal amount of space on each side, and I want to put a small space in the middle. I left a little bit less than 1/4 inch space in between the two lines. As you guys see, I'm trying to depict it right here for you guys. So I'm just using an eyebrow pencil to make a very pale line. I want to show you this pack of needles which I bought on Amazon. It's also linked in the description box, guys, because they do have really tiny needles, and I got 2 smaller ones in this pack. So there are 2 different sizes. There are like 4 or 5 different sizes in the pack of needles, and I'll be using the smallest needle first. And it's this white one here. I'm trying to show you guys it, but the lighting is just not showing you how small these holes are. So they're the exact same design like the regular crochet needle, except that they're a lot smaller. So they're able to punch holes in the lace that you get a nice, fine and seamless crochet thing going on without damaging the lace and making these really big holes, which the larger crochet needle would make if you were to use that. So guys, now I'm going on one side of the line, and I'll be doing the same crochet method. So this is like the invisible part of the crochet method that we would normally use to close off our crochet braid. When we do it on our natural hair, this is the same technique I'm using. It's nothing new that you have to learn. You're just taking a smaller needle and just using lace with it. So as you guys know, with the invisible crochet method, when we want to achieve that natural look, we only pull one piece of the hair through the loop like you guys see me doing here. So guys, I must say that this is like the quickest ever technique that you can use to get a crochet lace wig. Like, you know, they have like the ventilating method, which some people would use to get a crochet lace wig, but that's like if you're making wig as a manufacturer. And I personally would not do that because it takes days and I'm just not into that life. So if you guys want something that is quick and still get that natural effect, and you know, you want to save your edges, guys, this is definitely the best and most practical method ever. So I'm just going to do it one more time to show you guys exactly how it is done. So guys, this is what my parting is looking like so far. I've closed it up on both sides, and you guys, you can see how nice and seamless it's looking. Now we're gonna go ahead and fill in the rest of the hair. I'm just gonna show you guys how I did the rest of the lace, because we're not gonna take that big needle again. We're not gonna use that big needle that I started out with. We're not gonna use that on the lace at all. So we're taking the second smallest needle, which is this black one here. And the only time I'm using the method where I pull one strand of hair first is when I'm doing the center of the wig and when I am doing the hairline, because I want that to look natural. For the rest of it, I'm just doing the regular crochet method and just tying it just like I did the rest of the crochet cap. So now I'm going to show you guys how I did the hairline. This is how it is looking right now. And you guys could have made the center portion as thin as this hairline portion. That just means you take up less hair. It's not going to take you any longer. You just take up less hair. Because as you guys can see, it's still able to cover the hair at the back and everything when you pull it backwards. And as you guys notice, I left a little piece of the lace at the front. I didn't crochet the hair all the way to the front of the lace. I left a little bit out. So for the hairline, I'm just going ahead and taking tiny pieces of hair and just doing the same technique like I did, the same invisible technique to complete the hairline. Now for this overlapping piece of lace that is hanging out, I'm just going to stretch it to the side of the cap and then I'm just going to stitch it down with my needle and thread. And this is how the wig is looking, guys. Look at this cap, look at this wig, guys. I will be showing you guys in my next tutorial how I achieve these curls, but I just want to tell you guys I really love this hair so far. I really love this wig. I just think it's so cute, so easy, and it looks like a regular lace wig except that it's way cheaper. So I didn't want to make this video too long, so I'll be uploading the video sharing with you guys how I achieve these curls. That video will be coming on Thursday, so you guys can look out for that. I really hope you guys enjoyed this video and that you found it helpful. And if you did, I would really appreciate it if you go ahead and give me a thumbs up and also share it, guys, and leave me a comment. Also, if you haven't already subscribed to my channel and you want to see more cool alternative ways of achieving the easiest protective styles, go ahead, hit that subscribe button and also hit that notification bell. That way you'll not miss any of my weekly uploads. I thank you guys so much for watching, and I will see you all in my next video.